Do not fall victim to the short-term gratification that is whispering in your ear, telling you 5 more minutes is fine. You can sleep in. You can eat that just this once. You can take the day off. You deserve to take a break. Shut that voice down. If you do what is easy, your life will be hard. But if you do what is hard, your life will be easy.
There is no excuse for not living up to your fullest potential. No excuse. I told you, I didn't get a new daddy. I didn't get a new mama. What changed? I changed. And I stopped being a victim. I stopped saying, I've got to wait for good things to happen to me. And I said, I'm going to grind. I'm going to fight. I'm going to work. I'm going to press toward. I'm going to learn. I'm going to do everything in my power. Every single day, I'm going to do everything in my power to become a victor and not a victim. Winners win and losers lose. And if you create a culture of losing, if you keep being a victim, if you keep letting losing happen to you, if you keep letting people do you and treat you any kind of way, it's going to become a culture.
All in is not 50%. All in is not 60 hours a week. All in is not I work a Saturday twice a month. All in is not I missed one birthday party. All in is all f***ing in. You better learn to get really, really used to being uncomfortable, because nothing great comes from a position of comfort. Everything worthwhile, everything that matters, everything that is great comes from being in a position of uncomfortable. Nothing worthwhile is easy to get. Nothing worthwhile can you get by not being uncomfortable. Everything's gonna make you uncomfortable. Get f***ing used to it. And if you can get used to being uncomfortable, your f***ing limits are non-existent.
No one's coming to lift the weights for you. No one's coming to study for you. No one's coming to put in the hours for you. No one's coming to do all the hard work for you. You have to do it yourself.
Your habits are the building blocks of your life. It's what you do every single day that matters more than anything. Doing things that are a break from your routine are gonna require force. So you have to force yourself to be uncomfortable.
Are you making yourself better? Are you making yourself worse? Are you moving forward or are you moving back? Are you making progress or are you stagnating? Every little decision you make counts.
I don't wanna hear no shit about resting. I can't rest right now. I don't hear no shit about what I'm doing to myself. I gotta catch up now. And that's what life is about. Sometimes you are raised in a position where you are behind. We have to make that time up. I'm sorry, it may be inhumane. You may be unbalanced. It may not look right to you. I don't give a fuck. You gotta fucking save yourself, my friend. There's a lot of kids out there who live like you do, who have gone through what you've gone through. Maybe not as bad, but you're not the only one. No one really gives a fuck. You have to continue to fucking live your life, or you can choose to be doomed and become a statistic. The lessons aren't learned at the top of the mountain, my friend.
Those at the top who become the best, they don't let too many terrible days create negative momentum for themselves. They're obsessed about stacking great, productive days, back to back to back to back, because they know if you do that, the level of momentum created after a year, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, 10 years of doing this becomes so massive that you start creating automatic wins based on your daily routines.
Decide you'll do it no matter what. Commit yourself to the regime. You get up when you're supposed to get up. You study when you're supposed to study. You go to the gym when you're supposed to go to the gym. You work when you're supposed to work. You do whatever it is you told yourself you were gonna do long after the mood you set it in is left.
Everybody wants to prize, but nobody loves the process. Everybody wants to be a champion, but nobody's willing to put in the work that it takes to be a champion. Everybody wants to hold up the trophy and say, man, I did it, but nobody's willing to put in the work that it takes to do it. I love the process. I love the thought of working for what I want. And I firmly believe you're never supposed to wish for it more than you're willing to work for it. But a lot of people, they wish, and they're not willing to work.
So when you make your decision, make the right decision. The price of regret is much harder than the price of discipline. The discipline weighs ounces, the regret weighs tons.
You've never looked at yourself in the mirror and said, you let you down. Until you get to that point, you let you down. You want to put it on somebody else. The reason why I'm not successful is because of my boss. Have you ever looked at yourself in the mirror and said, I'm not getting up on time. I'm not going to work on time. I'm not putting in 120% when I'm at work. I let me down. You always want to blame other people. You want to hold other people to the fire, but you're not holding yourself to the fire. You just said you're giving 50%. You owe you an explanation. You owe you an explanation. You need to look at yourself in the mirror and say, why are you only giving 50%? What's wrong with you? You need to put yourself on punishment. You need to tell you, no more TV, no more snacks, no more desserts, no more, no, we working out now. No, no more alcohol, not right now. Not, no, I can't handle it right now. You need to tell you that you owe you something.
Take control of your feelings. Take control of your emotions. Take control of your job. Take control of your problems. Take control of your future and take control of your life.
You want to live a happy, healthy, successful life? You've got to pick to go through the pain now and enjoy the peace later.
The problem with some of you, you just hope that good stuff is going to happen to you. You got to get up and make shit happen.